So this is lesson 11. Let's start out with some ellipses. Just to warm up. Gonna go to skinny ones. And then wide ones. Okay, so then the ellipse leads us directly into working on curves. Another way of thinking about a curve is like this. If you have a line and then you go in opposition to that line, and then you see here this transitions between those oppositions, and you can do that any number of ways. You can do it staying closer like that. You can But we've been working on in class shaping beautiful curves. Curves have inside of them this. So another thing that's insinuated by this is a kind of triangle. So where you have any lines in opposition on the triangle, those are also open for smoother transitions. And these can be the basis of curve shapes. So let's try this. Composition of triangles. With overlaps. And then let's see what we can do to make connecting curves. Like here, we could curve this way. Kind of an interesting shape, right? Okay. Another thing I wanted to work on today is cubes. And cubes gives us an opportunity to practice straight lines. But I wanted to start a lesson we'll call one-sided. Two-sided, three-sided. And this is a really nice way to move things into the foreground. I'm fussing around because I don't want to hit this corner right there with the line that comes over. And then we can build on that. Like we can, these could be adding more one-sided pieces. Adding more two-sided pieces. More three-sided pieces. And here's a little bit of a lesson in drawing cubes. So you either have lines that are tending or you have lines that are straight. And that's kind of it. And when you're drawing a cube, it can really help to say that. And another way to think about it is lines that are fanning. So for instance, you can see that these lines are fanning. And by fanning, what I'm kind of talking about is, like, let's take this piece right here. What I'm talking about is you can see the presence of a point out in space that they're reaching towards. And so we have lines that are straight, like these, and lines that are fanning, like these. And if the other side is the same, there's a point out there in space that those lines are pointing towards. So these lines are either fanning or they're straight. So this is our two-sided. And then if you want to, and then looking at your three-sided piece, you can use the same points if you feel like it. But the three-sided piece, you see the top and two sides. See that we just see the two sides of this. This line would be fanning. That line would be fanning. This line would be fanning. Those would be straight, straight, fanning, or tending, and tending. And then above your head too is open for three-dimensional, for three-sided. Fanning, straight, tending, straight. We move back in space. And also up on the horizon line towards the center. This is the horizon line. These lines are fanning or tending. And if a piece was just facing towards you and it was far enough in the distance, its lines are all straights. There's a set of numbers that I try to keep track of when I'm doing compositions like this. It goes 90, 80, 60, 50, 30. Okay, so it's 90, 10, 80, 20, 60, 40, 50, 50, and that's 30, which would be 30, 70. And those are kind of places that I like. Those are sort of proportions that I like to work with. So for instance, if I'm building a square like this, and I have to add another square to this, I want to use, I don't prefer the 50-50. I love the 60-40. So where here's the 50-50. And if I come to about here, that gives me a 60-40 split. So if I'm looking for a square, like that's a good place for a square that goes with that one. Right the 60-40 split. Okay? Just practicing really nice cylinders. And the tools from today that we've been working with, if they can come together in a way that's really nice, then you might try this. So these lines are fanning. This line, they're tending lines. Okay. This line gains its direction from this line. And that's that line that an ellipse is built symmetrically on. I need the space of three tires. And then my fourth tire is where the car ends. This line right here, that's the line that this ellipse will be split in half on. And in class, we had talked about this, where from the axle, this line, again, is a tending line that goes with these lines here, or a fanning line. If you know where the other side of this ellipse ends, and it would be in keeping with this line, notice how this circle here for the middle of the hubcap is not in the center. Notice how it's towards the one side. And from our lesson today, if you think of this as a triangle right here, and then you ease the transition, you just come up with a way that you think would be nice to ease that transition. And you could do the same on the other side. We're just easing the transition. And it feels to me like I'd like to send this back further. And any of those lines can be played with. Like this is a triangle, and I'm easing the transition to the back like that. Anyway, just like playing with car shapes. It's a good idea. It's very like Pinewood Derby. All right, I'll do it for today.